Yeah, hello guys. Today I want to continue our discussion about examinations in NAM. Now what I want to talk about today is the e-exam that's held today. Now you know that our e-exam, our electronic exam, is a CBT. What do I mean by CBT? That's a computer-based test. Now, it is very important that while you are preparing for that, you should also learn to make good use of computer. As a study center director, I found that one of the challenges many of our students used to have is the ability to make use of the computer. But I will advise that what you should do, especially if you have not started and you have not been exposed to computer, then you need to go and get an exposure to how to make use of computer. Now the reason is this: you cannot be in an exam and be asking somebody else to help you to be keying your answers. So you should never allow yourself to get to that stage. If you are, these exams are usually for 100 and 200 level students, and that suggests that most of you are likely to be very young people. But it does not matter what your age is, because you know that our system allows people to come in without age barrier. So once you are admitted into National Open University of Nigeria, I will advise that one of the things you should learn to do is to master how to make use of the computer. Now don't think that it means you have to go and get a certified in computer science. No. The basic skills on the keys, make use of the keyboard, learn to answer your question, because most times what you do is that you have what you call the multiple choice and fill in the blanks. Now when you know the answer you want to give, you click on the choice that you make. And if you have actually been doing your TMA, that's so much assignment by yourself, I assure you that you should not have problem making being able to do your e-examination. And you know, some people even opt for what you call the virtual exam, in which they actually use only the computer to do the examination. It's also an option that is open to students in National University of Nigeria. It is important that you understand that the kind of university you have come to is the one that makes good use of the electronic system, of the virtual system, of online, because even your application was done online and you actually were given automated admission before you are processed through your certificate clearance and all of that. But what I see is that most of us, because we will not do these things by ourselves, we then tend to fall prey. We then tend to fall foul of what is required of us. Nobody will come and sit to fill an exam to do your examination for you. If you can make use of ordinary small phone, like what you call this basic one, it has keypad. With the keypad, you can type. Now, if you can type on this, your message, why will you not be able to type your answer? But the things that you are even required to answer in an e-examination is not so extended. Like I said before, it's multiple choice, which most of us call OBJ, and then fill in the blanks. So now, where you may need to do typing, you begin to fill in the blank. And for this reason, you should learn to, if you can make use of your cell phone, which I know most of us already have, then you should be able to make use of the keyboard. And the keyboard is QWERTY, that's QWERTY. That's what you have as a keyboard. So you learn to master that. And because you are not even in a typing contest, nobody will be on your neck to say that you have a number of words to type per minute. So the only countdown that you have on your computer is the time that is given, and I show you that you are given enough time to actually answer your questions. So type it, even if you have to pick, type them. And I always say this, and I said in my previous videos on the examination, I said that you should learn to do your activities in now. They are so simple that most of us just we don't pretend as if they are difficult. They're so simple that you can do many of them even on your handset, on your cell phone. You can do many of the activities that are required for you to do in now. But we'd rather contract these things out, and then we not get into trouble. So we should learn to make use of technology. And the technology required is a simple one. The computer is already provided by the university for you to use. So what you need to have mastered is how to use them, how to click on. They are set up. Like I told you, I was a center director, so I know these things. They are already set up, they are already prepared, they are already made active by the staff members. Once the computer works and it's on, that's when you are calling to come and sit there. So what you need to do is to log in your matric number or your login details as it is required, and then you start your examination, and when you are connected, it starts counting you down. You start counting down to the time that you're supposed to finish. Barring any unforeseen circumstances, we have all the time to do your examinations if you have read. But if you have not read, then you will be in trouble. And secondly, I want us to also take note of one thing. Don't go with cheating materials to your examination. Don't say because it is E. Nobody will take note of this. You are also checked. Because it is an examination, you will also be checked. And when you are checked and you are found to have... I've had a case that what a young man brought was actually a thing as simple as a wristwatch. But we found him out. We found him out. So don't go with cheating materials. There is no glory in it. If you don't care about your name, what about your parents? I said they have been encouraging you in cheating. If that is the case, then it is unfortunate. But there's a lot of honor in finding that you did your work yourself, and you are able to claim, oh, this work I did, this examination that I passed, I worked for it. There's a lot of honor in that. I hope that you will take note of all these nuggets I am giving you, and you will make good use of them, and you will be able to be proud of your result as a graduate of now. This is one university, and I'm going to do a video about that. Why now is the best choice for you? This is one university that the content that is given to you goes through a lot of processes before it finally released to you. And then when it gets to you, you can tell you, because even lecturers have to do what to copy and review for the articles to be published. And that is, we even have a more stringent process for our course materials. And this is why you need to just value this university where you are in. It's a university of quality, and you should ensure that quality reflects in you and on you. We are doing all we can to make sure that your experience in now is the best you can have from anywhere. Please, don't make us look like fools for doing this, but make us feel proud of you when you become our alumni, because you are going to deliver greatly wherever you are. Thank you for your time. My name remains Professor Iyapo Diomolara Uwabwezi, and the Dean Faculty of Arts. And for this reason, I feel bothered and bothered by many of you when you are not able to cope with the study you have come into. And that's why I've decided to be doing this series of videos. Thank you very much for watching. And do not forget to subscribe. Do not forget to like this video. Do not forget to share it among your mates. Do not forget to ensure that those that need this information get it. Thank you very much, and God bless you.